Only on Fox 6 tonight, the casino controversy.
Governor Walker made perhaps the biggest single economic decision of his tenure when he rejected the $800 million Kenosha casino proposal.
Yeah, and with it, 10,000 jobs. Now, Walker says the decision saved the state millions. Tonight, we are hearing for the first time from the losing side.
The Menominee tribal chair gives her first and only interview on the subject, and in a Fox 6 exclusive, our Mike Lowe travels to Florida to talk to the Hard Rock International CEO.
We really try to create something that has quality.
This is the Hard Rock Casino Resort in Hollywood, Florida. It is a sprawling complex.
And that's obviously
Chief Executive Officer Jim Allen is extremely proud of.
In front of you, that is the center bar.
So proud, he showed it off to Fox 6 on an exclusive tour. His dream? To bring all of this to Kenosha.
It's an amazing facility, you know, over 100 acres. And it really is designed to have not just, say, a Hard Rock Cafe or not just the casino, but multiple amenities and attractions.
To make that dream a reality, Allen and Hard Rock partnered with Wisconsin's Menominee Indian Tribe on a plan to build a casino hotel in Kenosha. The project included everything from a casino to a concert hall, from restaurants to retail shops.
This is amazing.
All wrapped in rock and roll memorabilia.
We have got a lot of Brian Jones from the Rolling Stones. Outfit Elton John wore on stage. This belonged to Les Paul. This is amazing. Stones freaks lose their minds. Love it.
We're in so many different businesses, so to have all those under one umbrella, because of, frankly, the additional revenue you can generate from the gaming product, you know, makes it really a destination, you know, in itself.
The proposal was opposed by the powerful Potawatomi tribe in Milwaukee, who feared a new casino just 35 miles away would take business and jobs from Milwaukee.
Hear that?
Groups opposed to the Kenosha casino launched ad campaigns designed to sway the public debate.
The future looks bright for Wisconsin.
Still, Hard Rock International spent $6 million on architectural plans, real estate options in Kenosha, and other preparations. But it wasn't in the cards.
I have informed the federal government's Bureau of Indian Affairs that I am not approving the application for a casino in Kenosha.
In a surprise announcement 3 weeks before the federal deadline, Governor Scott Walker made it clear he did not believe the bet would pay off for Wisconsin.
Therefore, I cannot put the taxpayers of this state on the hook of losing about $100 million or more now, and potentially even more in the future.
According to a report on the decision issued by Walker's Secretary of Administration, if the proposed Kenosha casino is approved, the Potawatomi will likely withhold future revenue sharing payments and seek a refund of all past lump sum and revenue sharing payments. Walker put the blame squarely on his predecessor, former Governor Jim Doyle, who had signed a compact with the Potawatomi a decade ago.
But in the end, what it really boils down to is there's more than 100 million reasons why we had to make this decision, and they all fall firmly on the lap of former Governor Jim Doyle.
And with that, the dream was dead.
Just gone.
The news landed like a meteor on the Menominee Reservation in Kashina and in the city of Kenosha.
With basically a wipe of the pen, and it's all gone for these people.
If one building could tell the story of Kenosha's hope and heartbreak over the failed casino project, it would be this one. This is the former Dairyland Greyhound Park, where the new casino would have been built. Now it is a reflection of how some in this community feel, both abandoned and empty.
It's nothing. It's an empty shell. The plan was to come and build a casino here.
Eric Olson spent years working on the project.
Oh, yeah.
He knows all too well the Kenosha-Racine region has struggled with some of the state's highest unemployment rates. In just the last 5 years, Kenosha's dog track closed, its manufacturing base eroded, and its cherished Chrysler plant,
it's gone,
disappeared.
It's gone. Mack White's gone. American Brass is gone. Alpha Lavelle. These are all, you know, very family-sustaining jobs that are gone, and now it's mainly warehouse.
The Gaming Commission estimated that Hard Rock would have spent $85 million a year in Racine, Walworth, and Kenosha counties, buying goods and services for the casino.
Have you cried over this?
Few have been more emotionally invested in this project than Menominee Tribal Chair Lori Bovine.
I'd be lying if I said I didn't for days. I mean, right, I can't, I had to stop reading emails.
This is Bovine's first interview since the governor rejected the casino project.
It kind of felt like somebody reached in and ripped the heart out. how I would characterize it is everybody lost in this.
Our Wolf River.
We also met with tribal legislator Gary Besaw.
A designated national scenic riverway.
On the reservation 45 miles north of Green Bay, where the natural beauty of the place hides an ugly reality.
It's not a good thing to go on air and to keep regurgitating the terrible health and social indicators of our tribe.
A University of Wisconsin Medical School report shows the Menominee tribe ranks last in overall quality of health, has the highest mortality rate, the highest obesity rate, the highest unemployment rate, the highest number of children living in poverty, the highest violent crime rate, and the highest number of single-parent households in Wisconsin. The 9,000 members of the Menominee tribe bet on the casino project as the last best hope to lift themselves out of poverty.
Try to address all those social issues that we do know so well. That was what the goal was.
Leaders of both the tribe and the city of Kenosha promised to keep fighting for the project.
And it would be a huge win.
They have the support of a bipartisan group of state lawmakers who just days ago held a news conference at the state capitol.
We just hope that he reconsiders.
Imploring the governor to reconsider.
But the facts are the facts.
But the governor says he's not changing his mind. And back in Florida, casino critics say Governor Walker made a good move.
Casinos are economic development like eating a quart of ice cream is dinner.
Paul Siegel of the anti-gambling group No Casinos says you only have to look outside of Hard Rock's Hollywood Resort to see that the promises of economic development are empty.
Local businesses around it can't survive. Restaurants, hotels can't survive when the casino can give away those things as lost leaders to bring you in.
Surrounding that casino are porn stores and pawn shops.
You know, the level of quality, the fit and finish.
But Hard Rock CEO Jim Allen argues the casino has made a positive difference in Florida and would have made a positive difference in Wisconsin.
And the thing we respect, there are different points of view when it comes to gaming.
Hard Rock CEO says he's still committed to his partnership with the Menominee and the Kenosha Project. But it's clear that Walker's move could mean that other casino investors will look across the border.
We tried to make it work, but in the end, we're at a point where it doesn't, and so we need to move forward.
In Hollywood, Florida, woo-hoo! Mike Lowe, Fox 6 News.
Superb job by Mike there.
Mm-hmm.
All right, well, hey, you like cheese? Here's your